This is probably my favorite story about my cheating ex. As many stories as I have on him, this one happened after we were broken up. He had left me for a girl that he was seeing on the side, and we hadn't spoken in months. We had both blocked each other on pretty much everything. But as most girls do, I do have my fake Instagram account, and he seemed pretty happy in his new relationship. I believed that until I got a DM from a girl. She sent me screenshots of messages and fake accounts that he had made to communicate to her. So he had literally been cheating on the girl that he was with now, with her, the whole time. I literally don't understand people sometimes. Both him and I were in the same friend group, mostly because we pretty much grew up together. So I talked to another member of the group about what we should do. Now, I believe in karma and that people get what they deserve, but who's to say that I'm not karma? So we decided to show up to his house with not only the girl he was cheating with, but all the girls he cheated on me with. And take care of this, I kid you not, game show style. The thing that shocks me the most about men is the audacity. I don't know what the comments are going to be yet, but I want to clarify one, that him and I were best friends for a long time before dating, so that's why we have the same friend group. Two, kind of bold to show up at someone's house, kind of also bold to cheat on someone, but we were neighbors. So we went in, microphone in hand, and announced each girl one by one. He was speechless. Like, he didn't even know what to say. If you've ever just seen someone, like, entangled in so many lies that he thinks that he's never gonna get caught for, all of a sudden get caught for all of them, that was it. When his friend went in, he was like, hey, do you have something you want to share with me? Like, what's been going on in your relationship? He admitted to nothing. So that's why we announced girl number one, girl number two, girl number three, until we were all there and he had no choice but to tell us the truth. So yeah, don't be a scumbag, don't cheat. And if you do, karma will happen eventually, even if it's years down the line.
Usually when my clients arrive for their appointment, they're not wearing any makeup. But this girl wore makeup to the appointment just to have me take it off and then do her makeup again. I thought that was a little strange, but after I removed her makeup, I saw her nose. The tip of her nose was bright red and even a little bit deformed. It looked like a really, really bad sunburn. I tried to avoid the area when I started doing her makeup, but eventually I had to put makeup on her nose. And when I did, it was just not working. Her skin was literally peeling off. The makeup would not stay. So that's when I asked her, is there something going on with your nose that I should know about? Let me also just say that at this point, it was starting to swell and was noticeably more red than it was when she got there. That's when she told me that she had recently been out of the country for a mission trip and that she had picked up a flesh-eating bacteria, which had affected her nose. Then she told me not to worry because she had been on antibiotics for months, and that the irritation on her nose was just her skin healing. For once, I was horrified, not my client.
4 years ago, I broke up with my boyfriend, Dan, but I decided not to tell him. Dan had been coming around to my apartment and my work, even though I repeatedly told him I was not interested. I had been planning to move to get away from him, and I didn't want him to have an excuse to be in my life. So when I moved away, I didn't tell him I was pregnant, and I didn't put his name on the birth certificate. Last year, when my daughter was two, I got married and my husband adopted her. Dan and my sister were still friends in high school, and since Dan still lives in my hometown, they occasionally catch up. A week ago, Dan called me and said that he found out through my sister that I'd been pregnant not long after we broke up. He was furious that I had never told him and that the baby might be his, and accused me of keeping him away from his daughter. I told my husband, and he's furious that I never told him about my daughter's father. He was always under the impression that her father hadn't wanted to be in the picture, and he's been cold to me ever since I told him. I do not ever want Dan around my daughter, and I think I was justified in my decision to protect her from him. But Dan keeps calling and asking to see his daughter, and my husband says I betrayed both him and Dan by lying about this.
Imagine TikTok being so powerful that they actually help you identify the person that almost murdered you. On my For You page the other day, I found this viral video that you guys might recognize, which states videos I took before almost being hunted and murdered. I clicked on her page, listened to her story, and was like, I have to know more. So I reached out and got the full thing. This is the case of Flowers Don't Growl. April 29th through April 30th of 2019, Taylor and her boyfriend Chris decided to take a trip to Falls Creek Falls, Tennessee. Taylor was 5 months pregnant at the time, so they figured they needed one last little trip before they were going to have a baby. And Taylor swore that Chris was going to propose. So that's why she documented so much of this trip, not even realizing that later on it was going to be used as evidence. So they set up at their assigned camping lot. They spent their time hiking, exploring, having fun. Taylor would collect flowers along the way to document it for memory's sake, but please keep these flowers in mind. And then on the second day, everyone from their assigned area was gone except for them. So they were more alone than before, or so they thought. So later in the night on their last day, they ended up hearing a loud crash. There's very windy roads nearby, so they figured that it was a wreck. And just to make sure kids weren't involved and that everyone was safe, they got out of their tent and ran over to the crash site, which was maybe half a mile away, to go check on the people. The sheriff ends up showing up and it's like a DUI situation, but everyone ultimately was okay. So before heading back to their campsite, Taylor says she has to go use the restroom. So her and Chris walk over to the bathroom so she can do her thing, and in the distance they see a light flickering. And as it gets closer, they notice that someone is running with a flashlight. So they're both cracking jokes to each other, like, oh my gosh, this guy really has to go to the bathroom. But once he approaches the restroom, he ends up stopping right at them instead of actually going into the bathroom. And states, and I quote, "Wow, you guys are fast. Creepy." Taylor notices that he has a weird smile on his face and feels really nauseous, but just associates it with the pregnancy. So just to be nice, they continue to have a conversation with him. But ultimately, this is where things go wrong. Story time. Someone tried to murder me on a school trip. So during my senior year, I started talking to this guy that we can call Tyler. And we all had to go on a school trip for a competition. During this, we had to stay in a hotel room and we were all assigned partners. Well, I didn't know this at the time, but I was actually assigned Tyler's ex-girlfriend. We can call her Penny. And when I found out she was his ex, I was like, you know what? Not a big deal. I'm probably just overthinking it, but she had a reputation for being psychotic. And I mean psychotic, psychotic. Since we were all in close quarters, it didn't take her long to figure out that I was talking to her ex, and she went crazy on me. She basically threatened me by saying that if she ever saw me with him again, I wouldn't be coming home to my family. I still honestly didn't take her that seriously until the next day she saw us kissing, and she left the hotel room to buy throwing knives for when I got back. So when I reached the hotel room that day, she was yelling at me, threatening me, and then she took out one of the knives. Part two to me almost getting murdered on my school trip. So when Penny took out one of the knives, she literally threw it right at me. Somehow it only managed to land 5 inches from me and I was okay. So I took off running out of the hotel room. I immediately went to our director, and literally because her parents fund most of the band stuff, he straight up couldn't care less. I told my mom, who happened to work with the superintendent's wife. So she told her the whole story and gave my mom his phone number. Let's just say they were suspended and the teacher was fired. She swore up and down that her and Tyler were gonna get back together, but it's been 3 years later and she's still crazy and he still hates her and I'm still with him. So I guess the moral of the story is, please take it seriously if someone threatens you, especially if it's a crazy ex.
My best friend's boyfriend starts DMing me on Instagram. He confesses that he had a crush on me when we were in college together, and I told him that I did too. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. From that day on, he would DM me every single day and we would just flirt back and forth. I started feeling really, really guilty, and I told him one day, I can't do this anymore. That's when he told me he also felt guilty and that the best thing was for us to stop talking, so we did. I was so sad. A few weeks passed by and my best friend asked me if she could have the apartment all to herself because she's planning a romantic dinner for him. I said yes, but I felt so jealous. Left the apartment because I realized that I was so in love with him. I went to the supermarket and ate a whole pack of Oreo cookies and went to the movies. I got a text message from my best friend asking me to come home immediately. My stomach sank and I thought she had found out. When I get there, she's crying and she says that he broke up with her. I asked if he said why and she said because he was in love with another woman. My stomach sank again. I was there with her the entire night while she cried, knowing her boyfriend left her because of me. My best friend's boyfriend had broken up with her because of me. I didn't have the heart to tell her. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. A few days later, she started going out on Tinder dates again. I could see that she was feeling better, so I decided to confess to her everything. And she told me she could tell that he and I liked each other. Then she told me I should date him. Well, I didn't waste any time. I sent him a text message and asked him if he wanted to meet up for dinner. And when we did, he asked me to be his girlfriend. We did it for 6 months before he proposed. He even got my name tattooed on his neck. The only problem is that my mom thinks he might do the same thing to me. I don't even want to think about that because I truly believe that he loves me. But let's hope not. I've been planning the wedding and I asked my best friend to come. Of course she said yes. She's super happy for me. And she actually has a boyfriend now. Do you guys think my fiance will end up doing the same thing to me?
Am I the asshole for not returning my bridesmaid's gift after the wedding was canceled? My friend Jessica, 28 female, was supposed to get married over the summer. She asked me and a few of our other friends to be her bridesmaids by giving us gift boxes. They were really nice. Well, Jessica's fiance got a call from her boyfriend, and the wedding was called off. Neither one of them knew about each other. We were all just as blindsided as he was. Jessica recently contacted me to tell me that since the trip isn't happening, she wants the bridesmaid's gift back. When I told Jessica that I had assumed this stuff was a gift, so I'd already used some of it, she got really mad and said that I should have saved it for the trip, and that I had to reimburse her for the price of all of the stuff.
What a tacky bitch.
Her and the maid of honor, her sister, are talking a lot of shit in the group chat that I'm stealing from Jessica. Am I the asshole? First of all,
can you solve this mystery? This is the story of 8 college students who went on a mountain climbing trip that went terribly wrong. One of them went insane and the other one went missing. But what really happened here and what are the rest of them hiding? All the clues are hidden in what I'm about to say. So these 8 college students decided to climb the tallest mountain in their area, but the weather took an unexpected turn for the worse and they ended up stranded there for 2 weeks, unable to come back down. After 2 weeks, a rescue team found them, but there were only 7 of them left. The 8th climber was missing, and the 7th climber had gone completely insane and had to be put in a mental hospital. The remaining 6 climbers made a full recovery, and when the police began questioning them, all their answers were the same. They say the 8th climber went to find help and never came back. Then the police went to the mental hospital to talk to the 7th climber, just to see if he knew something that the rest of them didn't. But when they tried to talk to him, all he did was bang his head on the wall and repeat, 8888. What happened to the missing 8th climber? And what drove the 7th climber to insanity? Can you solve this mystery?